Hey everybody, Alex Kazor, SteelersDepot.com, back to do another tape breakdown and analysis. Like I said, we're going to try to do this twice a week, usually midweek around Tuesday, Wednesday, and then probably Friday, Saturday. So that's going to be the schedule I'm going to try to adhere to. Talking today, Zach Banner. I know whenever I talk about Zach Banner, and certainly, you know, as Steelers Nation talks about him, it's usually for the fun stuff, the kneel downs, the little Twitter beefs, jokey stuff with Duck Hodges, and, you know, all the things that Zach Banner does. And we'll touch on that briefly here at the end of this video. But, you know, he is a lot more than just kind of the class clown and this kind of cult hero that he gets referred to. If he wasn't talented and had made big strides in the NFL, he wouldn't be on this roster, much less had on game day and seeing significant snaps, like 25 snaps against the Cardinals this past weekend, his highest percentage of the snap count the entire year. So let's show a little bit of love for Zach Banner as an on-field product, as a blocker today, and that's what we're going to be checking out on these several plays, all run plays against the Cardinals. So first play here, and the first thing you notice with Zach Banner, just how massive he is. I mean, Matt Filer is listed at 6'6", 330 listed, and Banner just towers over him, and certainly Vance McDonald. But more to the point, to the block here, this combo block working the second level to try to cover up this linebacker on this Benny Snell run. So look at it here, just a nice push at the point of attack to help Filer secure this block and this little pin-pull scheme with Pouncey pulling around so Filer can get his hip set. And then once you've secured the down block at the first level, now he's going to work to the second level. Cover up the linebacker, does lose him at the very end, and that is one issue with Banner. I think you'll see this on another play we'll show later in the video, but that is a tough spot when the linebacker is moving away from you. You don't want to hold and ruin a potentially good play. Still, I think overall, a nice block, and again, just secure the first level block. You know, we had a video a couple weeks ago where the Steelers really struggled to secure the point of attack, and that really created problems at the second level, and then be able to climb, just engulf the linebacker here at the second level, and I think overall make a decent block, good hand placement, drives his feet, and then doesn't hold. I'd rather lose that block and get the 4-yard gain than try to hold on to it too long and get called for holding and march yourself back 10 yards. So one last look at it here. Nice combo block, first level, second level by Zach Banner. Very next play, this is a 3rd and 1. So Steelers have obviously struggled in these short yarded situations for much of the season. There's been slight improvement lately, including against the Cardinals, and Banner here. Don't have to do much. You're just trying to get a down block, create a little crease here for Benny Snell. He's got a very defined run style, knows the type of back that he is, a downhill guy, and that's what Banner does here. So run it back here. Just this down block creates the lane, and Snell's going to follow behind. So again, Banner on the snap here on 51. Good placement, nice burst off the line, and then just secure this down block, set your hips, just drive this linebacker to the ground, and Snell's going to run off the hip of Filer and off the hip of Banner, and get 3 yards on 3rd and 1. So nice job here, one last look at it. Simple stuff, but again, physical, strong at the point of attack, secure your block, just create that little gap for Snell that'll get you the sticks moving on 3rd and 1. Jump ahead here to the third quarter. Kind of a similar scheme. Pin and pull again. This time Pouncey and Matt Filer are both going to pull. So you're going to get the down block here from Zach Banner by himself here on, consider that the 5-tech. And it's a pretty crucial block to make. Got to secure him. And again, just helping Snell. He's going to run off the outside hip, follow behind Pouncey. And I think this is another 4-yard gain. So not any huge runs, but this was what, 2nd and 6, I think they're going to switch to, maybe 1st and 10. Either way, put yourself in a second and manageable situation. So Banner just securing the down block. Got to have the front side contained, so Filer and Pouncey can pull around. You don't want to allow penetration on this play. If you allow penetration, it's going to have to help widen the path of Filer, and especially Pouncey, it's going to throw off the whole track of the play. So Banner secure, keeping his feet moving, not getting called for holding. Just a nice job to kind of engulf, secure the down block, set his hips. Snell runs off his hip, and it's a successful run for the Steelers. A couple more to look at from Zach Banner on Sunday. A little wildcat late in the game. Banner actually lined up as a left tackle here, so a little unbalanced look with Alejandro Villanueva shifted over to the right side, so a couple different wrinkles from the Steelers' offense. And this is probably the best play that Banner had, and this is just big man versus little man, at least relative to the NFL. You see him on 54 there. One of the outside linebackers here, and just totally engulfs him and just drives him downfield, doesn't let him disengage, and it's a nice 17 yard run officially for Deontay Johnson on this little reverse, maybe an end around, because Samuel's technically, I guess, the quarterback on this play. But just nice job by Foster too, but Banner, just good hand placement, keeping your feet moving, and just driving this outside linebacker downfield and not letting him make a play. So one last look again, Banner here. Just drive your feet, good hand use, and just again, big man versus little man, and it creates a 17-yard run for Deontay Johnson. Actually leads us to our next play, and again, it's small stuff. I'm not saying these are any, you know, Hall of Fame highlight reel plays, but I think just a really solid game overall from Zach Banner. Again, you do see him lose the block here at the end a little bit, but just getting a really good push here on this double team. Just helping wash this D-tackle, number 92. He does spin out of it, but at that point, Snell's hitting the hole, pushing the pile forward late in game, and getting some positive yards. So just a nice double team block with him and Fowler. That's a big group right there. You got Banner at 360, Fowler at 330, and just hoping to create some movement, get this D-tackle to wash down a little bit. Again, Banner loses it a little bit late, but by that point, Snell's already through the hole. Really doesn't make a whole lot of difference, but just being strong and physical at the point of attack, that's what the Steelers' run game had been missing for too many games this year, and what you're getting on this play. So nice job there from Zach Banner. And finally, just for fun, the one route that Banner ran on Sunday, and really he was open. I'm mad that Duck Hodges didn't throw him the football. You'll see how open Banner really is here. Yeah, there's a linebacker there, but I think Banner could take him in the open field. But yeah, open, little check release here from Banner. Hodges looks at it, then realizes who it is. It's number 72 and not a tight end or a running back. So Hodges pump fakes and brings the ball down and takes off for a decent gain. But yeah, so using Banner a lot of ways. He is eligible in this play. Didn't report eligible, at least not according to the box score, but he's not covered up by the linebacker because he is off ball, off the line of scrimmage a little bit. And you see the pump fake there from Hodges, who decides, nope, we're not going to do that, and slides for whatever that was, I think a 6-yard gain. So one last look at it just for fun. Right there, Hodges goes, oh, that's 72. Let's not do that one. But hey, Banner's run two routes this year, so maybe he does catch a pass, a goal line play. Obviously, that's if it doesn't happen, that's fine. But I know Steeler fans and myself included are kind of hoping to see it happen just for the fun of it, but hopefully in a situation where a game doesn't matter, maybe week 17 or end of game situation or something like that. But who knows? They're asking to run a couple routes, and so I thought that was just kind of a fun thing to show you guys. But overall, again, to the point, to the player himself, because he deserves respect and credit and praise for the on-field product. I thought Banner had his best game of the year against the Cardinals, used a lot. You know, if Vance McDonald can't play this Sunday, they're going to rely on Banner even more against a good Buffalo front that plays really stout and solid defense. Credit to him for dropping weight, transforming his body, getting back in the NFL. He's gotten revenge on teams that have cut him. They beat the Colts this year. They beat the Browns this year in one of their two matchups. Both teams that signed and then cut Banner. The Colts drafted him in the fourth round and cut him after training camp his rookie year. So a little bit of revenge for him personally. But again, he's back in the NFL, doing a really nice job. Fans love him. Good guy. But also doing a nice job on the field. And that's how you become the folk hero kind of the team, is when you get to make the team play and play well. So I think Banner's doing a really nice job in helping this team get its run game going, run for a 120 in three straight games. The first time that's happened in over 4 years. So Banner's been a big part of that. So wanted to give him some credit and talk about the on-field football product. Thank you guys so much for listening and watching, whether you're doing so on YouTube. Follow me on Twitter at Alex_Kazor, or follow on the website SteelersDepot.com. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll talk to you soon.